remember this hoodie? Do you remember this hoodie from anywhere?
I don't like that hoodie.
Why?
Because I just don't like that hoodie. If you
Why?
Know, you know. If you watch the vlogs, I don't like the hoodie. Alex pulled a prank on me and put like some other dude's cologne on her sweater, and I was jacked up for like a week.
That was so funny. You did the same thing to me with lipstick in the car, so.
Yeah, I know. Only because you did the cologne thing. It was retaliation.
Yeah, so.
I have a photo.
Do you want to go first or me?
I can go first.
Okay, go.
All right. So guys, this photo, I don't know if anybody's seen this. This photo is when Allie and I, this photo is when Allie and I went to the Trans-Siberian Orchestra with her grandparents.
Chichi man.
Look at this.
Oh, I want that picture.
Yeah, look at that.
I forgot that existed. Will you send that to me?
Allie looking good.
Will you send that to me?
Yeah. But this was us when we went to the Trans-Siberian Orchestra.
Em, you're so awesome. Thank you for all the rose bears. You're killing it tonight. Austin, I need that picture. Will you send it to me before you forget?
Yes, I will.
Okay, this is my picture.
Ah, yeah.
I love this picture.
Bro, that's a fire photo.
I want to frame this picture. Mm-hmm. You know?
Bro, that would be hilarious. I love it.
So this picture is of me and Austin at the cruise. Not everybody got off the boat, but we got off the boat in the Bahamas. And we, like, my eyes were hurting so bad because I had a headache that day. So me and Austin went through the straw market to try to find sunglasses. And these are the ones we picked out.
Bro, it was great. It was fun.
Everybody always comments Austin and I. I just, like, I love that's that right, picture of us. Right. I think it's so funny.
No, I think it is too. I love it.
So this song is actually me and Austin's song. Like, weirdly enough, this is our song. This is, like, I don't know. Me and Austin are both, like, hopeless romantics at heart. If you guys are hopeless romantics too, let me know. I put on the battle because I like for you guys to be able to see how many roses you guys are sending. Since y'all are still sending them, you guys are crazy. But this is probably one of my favorite, like, songs of all time. Does anybody else like classic music? This is all me and him listen to. Like, literally all me and Austin listen to. Do you guys like Louis Armstrong's voice? Okay, I don't know. I'm just only saying this because I know that people always know someone. So if you guys know Michael Bublé or someone that knows Michael Bublé, I would love to have him at my wedding one day. I'm just saying. Can I play it from the music box? Do you guys want me to show you? Did any of you guys watch me and Austin's Valentine's Day vlogs? Did you guys see they were both trending on YouTube? That was a huge moment. Huge moment. So if you guys watched me and Austin's Valentine's Day vlogs, you guys like will notice that he literally for Valentine's Day when he asked me to be his Valentine, he got me a music box and he took out the center of it and put our song in it. Like, I'll show you. That's how you found me? Our Valentine's Day vlogs? No freaking way. That was so fun. That was so fun. So you crank it and like, look at how cool it is on the inside. I love stuff like this. Isn't this the coolest thing you've ever seen in your life? I love this. is like my favoriteest thing he's ever gotten me. I just love, like, I love it. It's so special. Thank you guys so much for hanging with me tonight with my sun poisoning and all. Y'all are the real one. Y'all are the real one. Aw, Cindy, right? Our verse of the night, because you guys know we always like to end with the verse of the day, is 1 Timothy verse 6, chapter 6, verse 6. So 1 Timothy 6, 6. And this is what it says. Aw, Tammy, I love you. Oh my gosh, Tammy used to send the best, what were they called, Tim Tams. Oh. Anyway, but godliness with contentment is great gain. And it says, thoughts on today's verse. What determines our financial worth? Do we compute it in terms of dollars, possessions, real estate, or investments? Paul reminded Timothy that ultimate gain and the gain of incalculable value is really determined by a straightforward formula. Genuine net worth equals godly character and commitment. But what would happen if we realized the true... Hey, Colby. I'm having such a hard time reading.
You're good.
But what would happen if we realized the truly wealthy were those with godly character who found contentment in Jesus regardless of their circumstances?
Love it.
That's actually true.
Can you read the first verse again?
1 Timothy 6:6, but godliness with contentment is great gain. Like, I just think about, like being, like, rich in love, like, rich in mercy, rich in, like, family and friends. Like, I would choose that. Rich in godliness, like, being close to God. Like, being content, like, not comfortable, because I always think you're supposed to strive to grow. But being content and finding, like, your purpose and joy in every season is so valuable. And, like, I've been talking about that every night on live. Like, that is what I've been teaching myself how to do, is, like, fully being aware and fully, like, embracing the place that God has me at, not being comfortable in it, but being content in it so that I gain everything that he has for me in that season. And it is so amazing. Like, I would not trade that feeling for anything in the world, you know?
I feel like you kind of get to the point where you, like, I have a conflict with contentment, right? Because there's a bad content and there's a good content. There's a content of I'm fine where I'm at, I'm good, I don't wanna grow. But then there's a I'm fine where I'm at right now, I'm happy with the step that I've taken, I'm here, but I'm gearing up to take another step. And I feel like that is godly contentment, where you always wanna grow and be closer to God, but you are content with where you at, that you are content with the steps that you are taking. You know what I mean? I feel like it needs to be that to be able to grow in Christ. Because if you have the other contentment where you're like, oh, I'm content with just going to church for once a week and not really doing anything other than just going to church. Or, okay, I did my devotions one time this week. I'm content with that, but next week I'm going to go with two. Next week, then the week after that, I'm going to three until I like achieve. You know what I mean? To where you're, because I feel like if I'm not content with where I'm at, I can't soak up everything that I'm receiving. And that's right. Kind of what you said. I have to have that patience and that contentment to be able to consume it all. Because if I'm like talking to you and you want to be somewhere else, you're not going to hear all that I'm saying, because you're like, oh, I want to be here, I want to be there. I'm not thinking right. You're like half here. You don't get everything out of the season you're in. You know what I mean? It's a balance.
Do that.
Definitely a balance.
So good. Anyway. Are we going live when we leave tomorrow?
Live?
Yeah, where we're going tomorrow?
Yes, for sure.
We are?
Well, I am.
Okay.
I'm back.
Well, I will see you guys tomorrow night.
All right.
Love y'all.
Peace out.
Bye, Austin.